Yes, ladies and gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back, welcome back, welcome back to the Subjective Perspective Show, episode 91. We have an incredible show for you this evening. As you can see, we have the entire crew here of the Subjective Perspective, the gorgeous Lisa TSP, my other half in life, who I am so blessed to have in my life, the incredibly intelligent woman who does all the audio and all the back behind the scene kind of stuff that gets this sounding real crisp, and of course our little pumpkin Jerry Falcor the Munch. He is a Tibetan spaniel and he is the cutest little thing you'll ever see. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Subjective Perspective Show, and I gotta tell you, we're really excited this evening because we want to bring you a live performance at the Subjective Perspectives Living Room, Living Life Studio. So that's what we're doing at this point. And we're having a blast getting everything all set up here at the studio, which, you know, is indicative of the great times we have here at the show and the Bud and Roach Entertainment Network in total. You know, anybody that knows me knows the love that I have for humanity and knows that I've been on this tip since I've been a kid. So big shout out to my boys creating and rocking NYSkateboarding.com. You already know Ricky, Jay Sean, the whole crew out there, all the boys I grew up skating with in my teen years. You know, it really is awesome to see friends grow and do great things. And I have a lot of friends in my life that have done some incredible things, and people I'm meeting now that are doing incredible things also. So for me, I draw a great inspiration from that. And I want you to remember, everybody, you know, everybody who's successful has a critic and has many critics. But in the words of the late great Malcolm X, if you don't have a critic, you're probably not successful. So embrace it all, love it all, and realize that you are incredibly awesome, and even more awesome, believe it or not, the paradox, when you have ankle biters, people that are like little chihuahuas biting at your ankles, because jealousy's a crazy thing, and the more success you get in life, and the higher up the ladder you go, you realize that there's going to be a lot of people out there that are going to thrive in the negativity and thrive in the hopes that perhaps you won't make it. But you already know when that internal chatter is louder than the external chatter, you've mastered your reality, as they say. So just realize you are greatness. Ladies and gentlemen, we're about to get into some incredible live music here at the show. But before I do that, I want to get my mail open, and I want to give a shout out to a couple people that have been retweeting our tweets. And this is cool because, let me just get a couple things set up here. I got the old smart device, so don't mind me if it takes me a second just to get everything rolling. But this is what's cool about having access to the world at large through social media. You're able to connect with people and bring people into your consciousness, which in essence is global consciousness, because we all are one when you look at the idea of entanglement theory through quantum physics. And I want us to realize the importance of understanding that we are all connected, that there isn't just a definitive line between Lisa, TSP, and myself, that we are one based upon just the mere fact that the molecules, the atoms that make up the molecules that make up this thing called oxygen, carbon dioxide, all that good jazz, all the trace elements as well, that pressing against my cheeks are all those atoms and all those molecules, as well as pressing against Lisa's and little Jerry's and all of yours. We are living in a fishbone. The question is, would a fish ever know it was a fish unless it was out of the water? It's a philosophical question you gotta ask yourself. Who are we? Why are we? Where are we? And what is the future of this great species known as humans? I think it's an amazing thought process to get into. And last week we had the Hollywood acting icon, a gentleman who is high up on the charts on house music worldwide, Alexander Sky. You already know. And you also know him from great shows and networks, from Charles in Charge to the 80s to Nickelodeon, Disney, all that good stuff. Alexander Polinsky, good buddy of ours here at the show and network. We broke it down last week, so go back, check out that episode after you listen to this episode, and be part of the magic of what it is to be free in thought. Ladies and gentlemen, just about to get my shout-outs already here. And, you know, we have a lot of people that retweeted our tweets, so I want to first give a shout-out to Tope Samaj and Bernard Ryman and Tom Green. Yes, you, Tom Green. You know who you are. The king of independent television. The man who inspires all of us real artists out there. And we're looking forward to seeing you in San Jose in November, brother. And if you're listening to this or watching this like years later, this is going to be November 2015. Like 5 years down the road when I'm watching, I'm going to be like, man, what year was that? 2015, ladies and gentlemen. Tom Green doing huge things. So that was a retweet contest we did today. So we want you to link to our Twitter and link to everything we're doing on our social media, because we do give our audience every opportunity you want to get a voice on air with us. Tonight we don't have the lines open because we're going to be doing a live performance. So through Twitter, through Facebook, through Instagram, YouTube, we're able to connect with all of y'all. So that's the cool thing when we think about how fast of a connection it is. Years back in the 1980s, it would be pen pals. Right, hon? Remember that? Man, probably all had one back in like junior high or something like that. I love these mics. It's like a little further back and a little up more. Awesome mics. Cherry Hill, New Jersey. Cherry Hill, New Jersey was Lisa's.
Her name right now, but yeah, we actually went and met them.
You went and met your pen pal?
Yeah.
That's awesome. Lisa TSP, when was that, sweet?
Fifth grade, maybe?
That's about when I had one like third or fourth or fifth, or probably fourth, yeah. Actually. It was some kid in Japan.
Really?
Yeah, it was cool because, you know, you're... And then he sent the picture. I sent the pictures, you know, all that kind of cool stuff. And that cultural assimilation, man, I hope they're keeping that going in schools. I know it's something that's a bit lost, just like cursive writing, right? Script was mandatory. If you didn't know your script, you weren't going to pass whatever portion of that writing class in third grade, fourth grade
back in Long Island, New York. You needed to know your stuff. So it's crazy that now it's obsolete. And we have to think about that. You know what? Obsolete in the near future if we don't keep the culture and tradition alive. Everything changes. You know, we talked about that with Alex last week. Everything changes. And it's important the good, the bad, and let it remind you that you're alive. Ladies and gentlemen, I have another shout-out I want to give now. And this goes to our Button Roach internet campaign we did. And look at all these ones, hon. That's all just retweets. Isn't that crazy? So just retweet after retweet. Don't know if you guys can see it. Just all these retweets. Just super, super, super cool, you know? And I want to give a shout-out to everyone going down the line, all right? So we're going to go for it. Give me a sec. And starting off with the top. Oscar. O-S-Z-S-C-A-R-R. At O-S-Z-S-C-A-R-R. Shout out, brother. Ome Willem. And that's at K-A-A-S-J-E-4-6. Zatara Driftwood. Big shout out, Zatara, at Zatara, Z-A-T-A-R-A, Driftwood. Great character, Anthony Beechwood, in a great book, Meet Me in the Airport, that I had once read. Get your hands on Meet Me in the Airport. Amazing book by New Senior Cisco. Kathy Toland. Kathy. If you could see this, we have some beautiful driftwood back here that Lisa got off of the Carquinez Strait Banks in Port Costa, California. That's one of the funkiest places on earth. We used to live there in a little carriage house, and it was incredible. Ladies and gentlemen, Anita at Anita119091, big shout out. Hendrick Peter at Hendrick Peter 11. Anita, again, Scott, ED44, big shout out, Scotty. Jimbo Spaghetti, shout out Jimbo Spaghetti, at Grip A Doe, Elk Archer, big shout out, Elk Archer. Going down the line to at Dantes127, big shout out, Dantes. Atomic812, big shout out at Atomic812. Grandpa Will, peace, Grandpa Will. Thank you. Grandpa Will 4, that is at. At WalterWalter112, that's Walter via Twitter. And Willem, LULZSEC501. Big shout out to everybody that made our Twitter campaign happen. And a special shout out to Vinbot out in, I won't say where you are, but you have won the t-shirt of Button Roach Entertainment, of the Button Roach Entertainment Network. So that's going to be getting shipped out in about a week and a half. About 2 weeks, you'll be getting that. So stay linked to us on our social media, everybody, because we do giveaways, we do cool things like that, shout outs, and as you already know, we have a worldwide audience, thousands of views a week on our site, on our pages, you know, just thousands of unique views a month. I mean, grassroots, don't spend a dime. All I end up doing is talking to every one of our guests we have personally, and they believe in us, and that just furthers our belief in them. And many of these people are icons and people we have looked up to since we were younger. So for us, this is an absolute honor to have our featured guests on the Subjective Perspective Show. Ladies and gents, what I want to do is go into a little commercial break with one of our songs, The Subjective Perspective, and it's off of our full-length album recorded by my man Jeff out in Strong Island, New York. You already know what Jeff doing it hard, brother. One of the greatest musicians coming out of the islands and an incredible producer of music. I want to play a jam real quick, and this is a song that we wrote in reaction to the title of our full-length album is Urban Folk Kaleidoscope. Just go to iTunes, Amazon, anything that you can get your hands on, and you'll be able to get linked up to 10 tracks that are so worth every penny. Ladies and gentlemen, want to go really quick, and I'm going to step off of the couch and go into my headquarters where I'm about to go put on an amazing song by The Subjective Perspective. But first, let me get the mic unattached so I can walk with it and talk with it. There we go. These condenser mics are awesome that we got. There it is. Stuck. Beautiful. Ladies and gentlemen, this is The Subjective Perspective Show, episode 91. And this is a song in reaction to an incredible interview that we saw Keith Olbermann do with Scott Olsen, an Iraq vet who had his head fractured out in Oakland at one of the Occupy gatherings. And the song we wrote is titled Dead Peasant Uprising. And we want you all to kick back and enjoy the next, gosh, how long is this jam? And let me just get it all queued up for us as well. We're at 3 minutes and 43 seconds with a song titled Dead Peasant uprising.
The video artist is the premier location on the Button Roach Entertainment Network to find some of the greatest videos on the World Wide Web. Submit your video now for consideration to buttonroachent@gmail.com. Howdy, everybody. Would any of you like to have a photo featured in the Lens of the Week section on the Subjective Lens page on Button Roach Entertainment? Send your photo to buttonroachent@gmail.com and be the next feature.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Subjective Perspective Show. And this is episode 91. I wanted to play those two video artist commercial as well as the Subjective Lens commercial because those are the two new pages on the network, and I wanted to get those out to you before we start the live show right now. So that was a song by Lisa TSP and myself titled Dead Peasant Uprising, and we're about to give you a couple right now, live, free of charge. So you just kick back and enjoy everything that's about to go on. All right, let me put my smart device over here. Get this thing all set up. So we have now an incredible studio that we're doing this from the Living Room Living Life studio here in Santa Cruz, California. So ladies and gentlemen, we're about to get into something really, really special. And this is the first live musical performance at the Subjective Perspective Show studio, at the Living Room Living Life studio. And we're about to get into it. So let me pop my smart device right here. I'm going to pop the headphones on just to make sure that when we're jamming, it's going to sound tight. And everything's EQ'd out nice. And I can actually bring this up to you, sweetie. So right now, everybody, I'm just, for everyone listening to the audio podcast right now, I'm just setting up the microphone for everybody watching on video. You know what I'm doing. So this, possibly like that for us. There we go. That's nice. That sounds nice. Coolio. Okay. So that's in. Now I'm going to bring over the mic for the old axe. This is the old axe I talk about. Okay. Now, so ladies and gentlemen, gonna give you about 10 seconds just so we could check the EQing on this, the old mic check, as they call it. So we'll just do a little.
Better days are coming, y'all. Better days and nights. Better days are coming down. That old path tonight. When I hear that train coming, I reckon it be fast. Cause when it wakes, a trail of tears that I wish I could get back.
Sounds tight. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let me take the headphones off, because I'm not going to need those now. So that's cool. All right, love. And I said love to at least TSP, my other half. In life, musical duo, the show, just she is me. We are one. And this is going to be a great couple jams about to play for y'all. Nice sound it was, too, I thought. All right, ladies and gents, this is a cover I think I want to open up with. Titled Already Gone by a great musician named Rob Strumlin, who wrote this, I think with another co-writer. And he got it over to a little old band called The Eagles. You may know them, Glenn Frey, Don Henley. Gosh, a couple greats in there. Joe Walsh. Yeah, pretty great song. And they do a really incredible version of it. I mean, they are the ones who do it. So it's The Eagles, Already Gone, originally written by Rob Strumlin, another fella as well. We know Rob, though, because we played with him down in Santa Monica on Highway 1. On Lincoln, I think it's called at that point. It turns into Lincoln, but still Highway 1, Pacific Coast Highway, at Club Trip. And that was an incredible performance, incredible show, great audience. And we went on, I think, two people after Rob. I think we were going to go on right after Rob. Rob Strumlin and the Neon Sinners. So check him out, man. They rip, and his version is incredible of the song. Yeah. Okay, so this is Already Gone. Little cover. Thank you.
some people talking just the other day. And I get
that you kinda
put me on the shelf. Tell you I got some news for you, and you soon find out it's true. Then you have to eat your lunch all by yourself. Now we're already gone, and I'm feeling strong. Now I will sing this victory song. Made me stop and wonder why. Guess that you felt like you had to set things right. Now just remember this, my girl, when you look up at the sky, you could see the stars and still not see the light. That's right, because I'm already gone. When I'm feeling strong, now I will sing this victory song. Let me free. Ho ho ho. That's not me, 'cause I'm already gone. When I'm feeling strong, now I will sing this video song. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, that's Already Gone, a little cover that we do, a little rendition of, and that's originally written by Rob Strunlin and another gentleman, and that's our version of it, but that was made famous by the Eagles, and that's Already Gone, and their version's incredible, and we hope you really dug that one. It's a deep one that we try to put out there for this. For this jam, next jam, they're going to take a sip of my non-GMO. Lisa TSP was able to squeeze me late earlier today. Always go for non-GMO. Got ourselves a little lemonade here. Oh, that was awesome. That was awesome, awesome. Non-GMO juice. Refreshing, and you always feel better afterwards. Ladies and gentlemen, that was incredible. Incredible. Let me tell you, Lisa's voice, just so you know, now that you get see Lisa TSP, it's the voice of an angel, and it glues everything together, and it's an honor to be able to play music with her in our lifetime. She's one of the greatest voices on planet Earth. That's Lisa of the Subjective Perspective, and I love you, sweetheart. Okay, let's get into a little something that we wrote. Thanks, sweetie. Sorry about that. For people listening on audio, I dropped the one of the lights, but we picked it on up. I'd say a little old song that we like to call No More Skeletons Home. Now, this song is all about being honest in life. See, we have no skeletons in our closets. We keep it real. And that's what we want you all to do. When you're honest, you never got anything to remember. I believe that was Mark Twain that said that. Samuel Clemens. This is No More Skeletons Home by yours truly, The Subjective Perspective. Thank you, everybody, for tuning on in. And thank you, everybody, for your unwavering support and making Bud and Roach Entertainment and The Subjective Perspective Show, The Talk Fire Show, The Subjective Lens, The Video Artist, and everything we have on our network, a reality that people are inspired by. I woke up one morning, God gave me a gift. Every dot in the world has lost the truest sense of the myth. My head was hurting, my heart nearly dead. Pumping blood through my teenage years became my soul's defense. Now why do we fight? Day in the night, your religion ain't better than mine, and my religion ain't right. How about the people that choose to not let in something new? It's all about those who sandals on, I left far from home, destination to freedom to speak the words I desire, speak the words I desire. Thousands of bodies lost, millions of families torn. Of their war, and why? in the night. Your religion ain't better than mine, and my religion ain't right. How about the people that choose to not let in something new? It's all about those who refuse to let in something. And here is our song we wrote from our home about the people that want to believe that I am wrong. You can't change what I know. I know what I know. The truth has set me free. There's no more skeletons home. There's no more skeletons home. I love that jam. Wrote that after playing out in Long Island, New York on the North Shore at an old mansion. And started getting into politics on stage. And was playing in front of a more conservative audience. And I wrote that the day after that I got into a little discussion on stage, a little heated discussion. Not heated. The other person was a little heated. I was cool. And it just makes you think how so many people are misled by falsities and illusions and lies and in what we call in the world of doctoral studies epistemology. Why do we believe what we believe, and how do we acquire knowledge? It's a fascinating thing. People in authority and what makes anybody in authority have an ethical ground? These are things that we have to question and things that we have to hold people who do wrong accountable for, but the people that do good, we have to raise them up and give them a lot of credit. Ladies and gentlemen, that's another great jam that we did for y'all. That's No More Skeletons Home, and I want to play one more before we go into a little musical break for a moment. And I think I want to get into one that's going to shake it up a little bit, one that we call Ragtown Boys, and it's got a whole nother thing going on. It's got a little hip-hop meets a little laid-back soul. This is Ragtown Boys going out to all my people and all my boys I grew up skating with, and you know who you are. If you skated with me, before I do this, let me go check one of the cameras just to make sure that one of these other cameras are working. Give me a moment. This one went off, so let's see if the battery or if it was just because it did that.
Sometimes it does just do that.
I don't know, it's recording. That's cool.
Yeah.
So that's great. That's cool, yeah. Let me just check the other cameras, everybody. All right, we got camera 2 in the mix looking awesome. Let me check camera 1 really quick. See, we got 3 cameras rolling. It's really cool. Beautiful. That's awesome. Beautiful.
Can you see Nugget in that one?
Yes, you can. See that little monkey? Little munchkin in there. It's a little dark in this one, but in that camera, yeah. The other cameras would seem great. All right, ladies and gents, let me get back into my spot. I dig these live performances. This is very, very cool. And for everybody that knows, the Subjective Perspective Show is going to be having other performers come on in and sit on this couch and do exactly what we're doing right now. And it's going to be incredible. You know what I'm talking about? So, again, everybody, just share tsp.buttendroach.com with everybody you know. www.buttendroach.com. Just Google it and just keep on sharing it. We're reaching the masses. And it's all because we work out of the medium of love and hard work and belief in ourselves and giving. Even when we have only 2 pennies, we'll be giving you all 1. And who knows, if you're really in need more than us, you're going to get the other 1, and we're going to figure it all out. Ladies and gentlemen, this is ¶¶
is Ragtown Boys, ladies and gentlemen. Kick back. Put that music up in your car, in your Jeep, in your truck, whatever you're driving, on your boombox, on your bike. If you got your headphones on, put this up. Because this is a jam that's going to knock your socks off. This one is one of the greatest songs out there. Ragtown Boys, if you're a skateboarder, you got to rock this jimmy. Incredible. I say what I be understanding. Is it a blessing? I'm guessing breaking down life with incredible sessions. Nature fills my bloodstream on a daily routine. So keep it clean, captivate your energy with the touch of my beam. Looking forward to the day where everything can be seen. Hanging around with Ragtown Boys always brought me tremendous. I'm coping, bringing out your strongest emotion. My notions make you feel like I could be floating across these skies. Through the visions in my mind, through my eyes, all the plans with the vibes. This is how we did it on the streets of LA. People staying mad nights, living like they're inclined. Everybody rewinds. I take y'all back in time. These are your sides. Chop away the walls in your eyes. These are the purest of times when people didn't sweat a dime. Like provoke thought to the meaning of life as we embark on these new times. We stay nice, decline to take the word from the unwise, reply with knowledge obtained from my past life. Strive, no doubt, live my life on a cloud, baby. Hanging around with Ragtown Boys always brought me tremendous joys. Whenever I got blue, I skid away in my DC shoes. When you know up all night by the lake in the firelight, all the boys that be huddled around drinking cake cups with all the pretty girls in town. Ooh yeah, baby, yeah, give them that voice, honey. Pretty girls in town.
Ragtown Boys, ladies and gentlemen, you already know where you heard it. The Subjective Perspective Show. That is Lisa TSP's angel voice, little Jerry TSP. And you already know, family, we love you. You already know, friends, we love you. And critics, thank you for empowering us. Because that's how all the success has been gotten in our lives. And the great ones understand the power of the critic. Ladies and gentlemen, let me go over to our switchboards and get us going with one jam by us, The Subjective Perspective, 2 minutes on it. And this is a great song that we got into a couple years back. This song's titled Real Romance. Enjoy this. 2 minutes, 32 seconds. Be right on back.
You sit over there and you stare. Oh, I sit over here and I'm aware. Oh, this frustration's vibing through my soul. Where to go to let these words go untold? I'm aware that you're way over there. I may not get the chance to see.
Episode 91, The Subjective Perspective Show, live in studio performance. Let me get back over to my acts. And I think I want to also give another shout out to some people that have been following us at the Button Roach Entertainment Network and The Subjective Perspective Show. So let me get into that. I always want to give a lot of love out to everybody that supports us. And when I mention critics, there ain't many out there, trust me. But I tell you this, we just appreciate all of the greatness that you have been giving us over the last nearly 4 years, and it's incredible. Ladies and gentlemen, nothing but love, quite frankly, that we get from everybody. So, but we know how it is, and trust me, there's people out there in life, just in general, that are jealous people. And I think one of Fat Joe's greatest albums, The Jealous One's Envy, you know what that is. Ladies and gentlemen, life is good, and it's even better when you listen to The Subjective Perspective Show and the Button Roach Entertainment Network. And I want to give a big shout-out to a couple people that have been following us on the Button Roach Twitter. So we want you all to go to our Button Roach Entertainment Twitter, and that's just at Button Roach. And some of the people that are following us, just want to give a little love out to some awesome people. Mentioned a couple people earlier, but also want to go to Jacopo. Jacopo Turned at that would be his actual at name, JAKOPORETURNED.
Michael Weston, real Michael Weston, Johnny Six, the Johnny Six, John Hoving. Want to give a big shout out to John Hoving also. Earl Skakel. Want to give a big shout out to Earl, who we got to talk on the Tom Green Show a couple months back now over the summer. Earl's a funny cat. If you're in the L.A. area, go see Earl Skakel, Dean Del Rey, all those guys. All of the Death Squad crew, Brian Redband's crew, they are funny. And just support that crew right there. Just a couple other people. Want to give a big shout out to TG Webervision. That's Tom Green's Webervision. They are awesome and they're on our thing. And the Good Times Show. Big shout out to the Good Times Show. We appreciate everyone that stays linked to us. And that's just a couple people. But want to give a big shout out for all of that. Because it's important to us to recognize those that support us. So, ladies and gentlemen, with that said, let me put my smart device down. And let us get into another jam or so. And rock and roll. Fun night. I love this. Okay. And I'm going to pop this on down. Okay. All right, ladies and gents. Got one more jam for y'all right now. And this song is a cover meets original. So we're actually going to do a cover of the great John Prine and his song, Angel from Montgomery. And we're also in the midway portion of that. We're going to transition into one of our originals titled The Chords of Love Interlude. So when you hear that, you'll know that it's a little transition into one of our originals. That's about a minute and 34 seconds long. And then we'll go right back into John Prine. So it's a really cool thing we do. We've played it at On the Rocks, at the Roxy on Sunset Boulevard. And that was an incredible show that we played. And I remember that was one of the highlights of that show was playing there. And that's one of the last places, the last place I believe that the great actor, late great actor John Belushi and comedian was. And John Lennon used to play there. And big happy birthday to my mama and John Lennon October 9th yesterday. And Alex Polinsky, October 7th I think it was, man. Alex, forgive me if I'm wrong, but I think it was the 7th. 7th or 8th, but I believe it was the 7th. My father, my old mama was another child that's grown old. It dreams with thunder and lightning with desire. His old eyes would have burnt out a long time ago. Hard way to go. When I was a young boy, I had me a cowgirl, which wasn't much to look at, just a free rambling name. Now that was a long time, no matter how I try, these years go by like they are broken down down. Make me an angel who flies from Montgomery. Make me a poster of an old rodeo. Just give me one thing that I could hold on to believe in this living is just a gentlemen, that is John Prine's Angel from Montgomery, and that's our rendition. And also snuck in there, the Chords of Love interlude, that's our original. I can't thank you all enough for staying linked to us here at the Subjective Perspective Show, everybody. This has been an incredible live episode 91, and these live performances are going to be happening a lot more. Just so you all know, we just want you to stay linked to us and to continue to spread the good word of what we do here at the Subjective Perspective Show and the Bud and Roach Entertainment Network. Ladies and gentlemen, this is yours truly, the Subjective Perspective, Lisa TSP, yours truly, Nick TSP, and little Jerry on the ground right now. Lisa TSP about to pick him on up. There's a little pumpkin. And we just want you to make sure that you have an incredible weekend ahead. And this was just a nice short for the most part, because we usually do 2-hour programs, but we wanted to just give a nice live performance this week. Next week, we'll be back with Charlie Overbay. Going to be incredible. We got an amazing lineup coming up the next couple weeks. Just make sure you stay tuned. You let everybody know where the real talk's happening. Don't ever forget, you have the power to change not only your life, but the lives of people around you. You are greatness. You are amazing. You are what you've been waiting for to make a difference. It all starts with you. We found that in our life. Born and raised in the working class, working poor streets of Strong Island, New York. Anybody that knows those streets, you already know. It ain't easy out there. And I got to tell you, we made our life the paradise it is, based on truth, love, and total loyalty and dedication to the great people around us, one another, and as well as our family and friends. And all of you, our newfound friends, our audience of the Bud and Roach Entertainment Network. This is episode 91. That was an incredible live performance by yours truly, The Subjective Perspective. And next week's going to be an amazing 92. Just the most important thing from our perspective here this evening is to remind you all of the magic within you. Don't ever forget, you are amazing, you are great, and you have the power to manifest a reality that goes beyond your wildest imaginations. When I tell you this, I'm somebody that knows the power of thought, and I know the power of greatness and honesty. Be that person that's honest, and you'll realize all around you becomes this incredible force field of love. Ladies and gentlemen, we want you to go into your weekend a bit more thoughtful with a subjective perspective. Peace and love. Until next week, just enjoy every moment you got and tell the people in your life that you love them. Peace always, ladies and gents. Thank you for staying linked. TSP.buttonroach.com.